Hello everyone, welcome to Masterminds. In this video we are dealing with the chapter 4 from class 6 geography, maps. You might be familiar with maps such as Indian map, world map, etc. So what is map? Map is a representation or drawing of the earth's surface or a part of it drawn on a flat surface according to a scale. We know that earth is in a spherical shape. So, the drawing of the earth's surface or a part of the earth's surface is drawn on a flat surface. Flat surface means it may be a paper or any other flat surface. Oh, but the map is based upon a scale. Scale means it is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. For example, if you are representing a 500 meter on the ground into a map, it is difficult to represent the 500 meter on a paper. So we use the scale such as 5 centimeter is equal to 500 meter. I am telling an example, okay? We are considering that 5 centimeter is equal to 500 meter. So we can represent 500 meter on the ground as 5 centimeter in paper. So if you are representing 1000 meter means you can represent it as 10 centimeter in your map. So, the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map is called a scale. Actual distance means from the example you can see actual distance is 500. Then distance shown on the map is 5. Therefore, the scale will be 500 by 5 which is equal to 100. Then there are different types of maps such as physical maps, political maps, thematic maps. Physical maps explains the physical aspect of a place. Such as if a map explains the mountains, rivers, lakes and forest of a place, such a map is called a physical map. Then political map explains the city, state, country or boundary. If a map explains different states of a country, then such a map is called political map. Or if a map explains different country in a continent or different countries in the world, such a map is called a political map. Then thematic map explains the roads and railways in a specific country or a specific place. Such maps are called thematic maps. We already told that map is based on scale. But there are many other representation also such as sketch and plan. But sketch is not based on scale. Sketch is just a rough representation. But plan means it is a large area is expressed in small scale. That is called a plan. You might be familiar with the plan of your house or your office or school. Means large area is expressed in small scale. Then there are different components of map. There are three different components such as distance, direction and symbol. First one is distance. We have already discussed what is scale. Scale means it is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. And on the basis of scale, there are two different types of map. First one is large scale map and the second one is small scale map. Large scale map represents a small area but it gives more information. For example, if a 500 meter on the ground is expressed in map as 5 centimeter, then it is called large scale map. If you are expressing the same 5 centimeter for 500 kilometer on the ground, then it will be a small scale map, but it expresses a large area. So small scale map have a large area, but it have only less information. An example of small scale map is world map. Then next component is direction. There are mainly four major directions: north, south, east and west. Then these points are called cardinal points. You can see this is the north, this is the south, this is west and this is east. And there are many intermediate directions also: northeast, northwest, southeast and southwest. The area in between, direction in between the north and west is called northwest. Direction in between the north and east is called northeast. In between south and east is called southeast. In between south and west is called southwest. And these are called cardinal points, and there are 8 cardinal points. Then the third component is symbols. Conventional symbol means it is the symbols which are internationally accepted. They do not change with the change in language or change in place. For examples of some of the conventional symbols are: blue color indicates water bodies, brown color indicates mountains, yellow color indicates plateau, and the green color indicates plains. Here are some of the symbols for railway line. These symbols are used for broad gauge. This is the symbol, meter gauge, then railway station. For roads, metal, these two straight lines are used, and in unmetalled, two dashed lines are used. Then for post office, PO is used as a symbol. Then post and telegram office, PTO. For police station, PSC is used. There are various conventional symbols used. You can see it from your NCERT textbook. So these are about the different components of map. So with this, we are done with session. Hope you can follow me. And if you find it useful, please share with your friends. Then like, share and subscribe. And thanks for watching. Have a good day. Bye bye.